Hi guys, welcome to my channel. Welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make these ascent mirrors using only skewers and toothpick, a carton box, and some mirrors. You can buy cheap mirrors at the supermarket, or you can repurpose your old mirrors. For those who don't know what skewers are those sticks that they use to make mishikaki. Sijui kama ushaenda kwa street nyama ikiuzwa kama imeko kwa vijiti. Sasa hizo vijiti ndo zinaitwa skewers. So when you go to the supermarket, you will find them and they are very very cheap. One packet goes for 70 shillings and I bought two packets and I still have some left over. You guys, I love how these mirrors turned out. So let's get right into the video. Stay tuned and watch how I made these ascent mirrors. For this project, we're going to use a surgical blade, a pair of scissors, wood glue, a mirror, and your skewers. I had already glued down my mirror on my carton box using the wood glue, so I'm going in with a surgical blade just to create an outline where I'm going to cut the carton using my scissors. And then I'm going to use my scissors to completely cut off the excess carton from the mirror. The reason why we are using the carton box is because we want to create a base for the mirror where we're going to stick down the skewers. And then I'm going to measure my skewers to size according to the design I want and then cut them. Here I'm using my surgical blade to cut the already measured skewer. Basically, I'm cutting down the skewer because this is a small mirror, and then applying glue to the skewer and placing it on my mirror. So I'm going to let you watch the rest of the video and see how I cut it. So I let my mirror dry for a few hours and then I went in with my surgical blade to scrape off the excess wood glue. So you want to slant your blade and then gently scrape off the excess wood glue.
You're going to do this in the rest of the areas that you have excess glue so that you can achieve a neat look. Here I'm dipping my skewers in wood glue and placing them at the back of the carton. So first I found the middle of the carton and then I placed my skewers with glue on them. And you're going to need your skewers hole, and the pointed areas of the skewers are going to face outside. So I went back in and refilled the large areas. You can do this, or you can completely fill in the gaps, or you can leave large gaps. It all entirely depends with what design you're going for. Here I'm going in with a toothpick so that I can create an illusion in the areas that I left. I did not want to cut down skewers. And then I covered the back with a piece of carton and then put some weight on it so that it can dry firmly. For the large mirror, I drew a circle at the back and then I glued the skewers around the circle. And then to create an illusion like the small mirror, I pushed the skewers a little bit further down so that I can create the illusion. And then for this, you're going to need support. That is why you can see I have some books around the skewers. You're going to need support before the glue dries. Once you're done with the design, you're going to cut a piece of carton and cover the back and place some weights on top of it so that it can dry firmly and together. So this is what the mirror looked like at the front. Unfortunately, I lost the footage when I was making it, but this is how it turned out. So here I am going in with some acrylic colors. This is in Van Dyke brown, and you need a brush and some water and a palette. So I'm just going to place the paint on the palette and then paint the skewers. You can leave the skewers as is, but I was going for a rustic look, so I painted the skewers in dark brown. Oh, and by the way, be very careful when you paint. These things are sharp. Actually, they are painful when they pierce you, so just be careful. So here I'm going to improvise and use masking tape as a double-sided tape. We fold it into two, ensure that both sides are sticky. So sticky side at the bottom, sticky side at the top. This is only temporary because I wanted to show you guys how the mirrors look on the wall. So I'm just going to do this to both of the mirrors and then stick them on the wall.
Thank you guys for watching. If you tried this DIY, make sure to tag me on Instagram. Meanwhile, stay safe and stay at home. Peace and love. Bye.